needs to be, so we were talking about burring.
Yeah, you do. I mean, once you drill the hole, especially on the backside, you'll have the burrs hanging out.
Okay.
And you need to get rid of those. So you take a bigger drill and you just touch it.
But why
very lightly.
Why couldn't?
Because you don't want to. You put a little chamfer on there, but you want it to be a small chamfer. You don't want it to be a big chamfer.
No, but why couldn't you take a? Have you seen plumbers?
You can.
Yeah, something like
this
that.
Is, if you have a straight edge, like here, if you wanted to deburr this has a sharp edge here, you could just drag this along the edge, and you can see the chips coming off.
Okay.
So this is a good deburring tool.
And the idea of deburring is because of metal fatigue or something?
Well, it's so, I mean, if you're rubbing your hand on it, you don't want to cut yourself.
Right.
I mean, it's a lot of different reasons.
Okay.
It's just standard, standard shop practice.
Okay. What were the twist ties for?
Standard workmanship.
Kind of
like if you've got the fabric over this edge, you know, you don't want it cutting into the fabric.
Correct.
So
you deburr.
And you don't want to go crazy because you can, if it's a hole, you can enlarge your hole.
Right.
If you
use the drill, if you were saying. Now, what were the twist ties for? Just to hold things on at
I
one time?
I have no idea.
Okay. There's no purpose for them.
There probably was at some point.
Okay.